Good vibes and nuggets.
From last week's message, Sunday, May 16, done by Pastor Donette Norman. Message title, Thy Will Be Done. God's will is His sovereign purpose, plan, and design as it relates to everything and everyone on earth. James 4:15 says, For that we ought to say, if the Lord will, we shall live and do this or that. We need to pray the will of God in our lives. Our prayers should earnestly come from a heart that says, Let your will be done, and mean it. This shows that we are trusting God and His leading. At salvation, when we gave Him our lives, He took our lives and put it in Him, and He has a purpose for us. However, He did not take our will from us because He didn't want us to be robots. He wants for us to say, Lord, let your will be done. Some general things that are a part of God's will include that all men be saved and come into the knowledge of the truth. 1 Timothy 2 verse 4. God has a will for His church. God's church is who He has called out to be a part of His bride. God wants to sanctify and cleanse His church. Ephesians 5 verse 26 and 27. God's will for us is to be heirs of God and joint heirs with His Son Jesus Christ. Romans 8 verse 17. There is a condition for being the Son of God, and that condition is that we must suffer with Christ so that we can reign with Him. That the saints be perfected and the body of Christ be edified through the fivefold ministry. Ephesians 4 verse 11 through to 16. God also gave the Holy Ghost, which is a comforter that will lead us and guide us into all truth. Oppositions to come into the will of God. These include ignorance of how God works and the awesome work of God at salvation. Pride. When we exalt our will above God's will, that's pride. God resists the proud and gives grace to the humble. Whenever we say no to God, it's pride. It's God who works in us both to will and to do His good pleasure. Philippians 2 verse 13. Pride is tied to disobedience. Obedience to the will of God is humility. Fear blocks us from following the will of God. Just say yes. There's absolute peace when we say yes to God. To counteract fear, God puts the Holy Ghost in our lives and leads us to help guide us. How do we find the will of God? James 4 verse 7 says, Submit yourself to God, resist the devil, and he will flee. 1 Peter 5 verse 5, Submit yourself to the elder. We need to follow the examples of those He has set over us as long as what they are saying is not contrary to the word of God. God is a faithful God, and when we walk in His will, He will establish us in various ways. How can we know we are in the will of God? He works His will in us, and His will is always in the Word of God. When He does, we will know because there will be growth in us in the character of Jesus Christ. We are led forth inside of the attribute of the kingdom of Jesus Christ in righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. God's perfect will is that we be not conformed, but be transformed by the renewing of our minds. Romans 12 verse 2. God's will is that we become children of God, that we walk in the virtues of Christ and manifest His life in a given situation. Romans 8 verse 29. Walk in the will of God. The opposite is to walk in the will of the devil. The devil's will is to kill, steal, and destroy. I prefer the will of God. How about you?